Hello, this is Dr. Alan Yim. In this video, I'm going to be introducing cadences. Cadences are goals, harmonic goals, that usually come at the end of a phrase. So what is a phrase? Well, a phrase is any complete musical idea. So maybe something like this. Okay, we might call that a phrase, and at the end of it comes a couple of chords, which we'll look at in a little bit, that sort of signal the end of the phrase. And you probably have heard chord progressions like this that also signal an ending. And I'm going to introduce these cadences from the strongest to the weakest. So the very first one I'm going to introduce is the perfect authentic cadence. So a perfect authentic cadence is a root position 5-1 chord that in which the soprano ends on 1. So it ends on do. And this is the one I just played. And I'll play it as written here. Sounds like this, in C major. One way to recognize this cadence is that the bass leaps from so to do because it's in root position. Last note the soprano ends on, it ends on do and filled in. The next three cadences I introduce are imperfect cadences. All of these cadences are final. In other words, you can end the piece with these cadences, but the next three are imperfect. They're weaker cadences. They may not end the entire piece. They normally would end a section or maybe somewhere in the middle of the piece. So let's take a look at the three types of imperfect authentic cadences. The first one is a 5-1, but one of the chords is inverted. So typically, as you can see here, I inverted the 5 chord here. And you can see that we have B in the bass. This is really helpful because this helps the bass to step, but it makes the cadence a little bit weaker. So listen to this. Stepping up. Now, as you know, the 6-4 chord, second inversion, we wouldn't normally use that chord except for very, very specific cases. So I'm not going to show it as a 6-4. We could also invert the 1 chord so we can have this ending chord. So we can have something like that. And that is an imperfect authentic cadence, but one or both of the chords are inverted. Another type is if the soprano does not end on do. So here I give you an example where the soprano ends on mi. It could also end on so. Sounds like this. Okay. And notice the bass still is in root position, but it doesn't quite sound as final because the soprano, instead of going down, it goes up. Also have it go to so or stay on so. Here's a perfect example. So it's 1-5-1, and in this case, I should play it in root position so you can hear it. But so even though I play in the bass, the melody ends in the middle of Mary Had a Little Lamb on so. So this would be an imperfect authentic cadence in which the soprano is ending on something other than do. So. Okay, it goes mi, so, so. The last type of imperfect authentic cadence is the leading tone IAC. So here you see number 3. I use a 7 chord, and again, since this is a triad, I'm going to only use this triad in first inversion, so it's B diminished over D. You might also notice that in this chord, when I double, I do not double the leading tone. So never double this, the leading tone, T. The reason for this is that T, as you may remember, always wants to go to do. So T, do, is the normal resolution, 7-1. So when you hear this, it wants to resolve up. If you double it, it's implying parallel octaves. So double anything but 7 in this chord. And here we have... sounds like a 5 chord. Remember, the 7 is a little bit like a substitution. The one note that it's missing, of course, is G. In this case, the root of the 5 chord. So it's just one note difference. Instead of a G, I have an F. So here's a 5. Let me play a 5. This is a 5. And this is a 7. 7 just sounds a little bit weaker, and 7-1. Uh-oh, I see I made a mistake here. I wrote a parallel. Okay, so do you see the parallel here? Parallel octaves. So I would have to revoice this. Maybe I would, instead of doubling the third, maybe it would be better if I doubled the fifth of the chord, the F. So I'm not going to do this right now. But let me just play again this first example I started with this Mozart. Okay, so we have a little subphrase, the first couple of measures. It goes 1, 5. So this is 5-4-3. This is a second inversion seventh chord. Back to 1. So what kind of cadence is that? 5-4-3-1. Would be an imperfect authentic cadence because the 5 chord is inverted. And then it goes on. This is 4, it's in second inversion, so this is just a pedal. And then, what kind of invert chord, what kind of a cadence is this? Well, you can hear the bass. Stepping. If you hear the bass step, you know it cannot be perfect because the bass must leap from so to do if it's perfect. This is stepping, so it's an inverted. And also the soprano goes with a little trill. So it's an imperfect authentic cadence in which the bass steps up from 5-6-1. And the soprano steps down in contrary motion to me. These are all the kinds of cadences that you can use to end a phrase or a section. In the next video, I'm going to talk about two other types of cadences that are places to pause or end a phrase, but which require going on, which require moving on in the music. Thanks for watching.